Oh, mercy, Welsh. Hello everybody and welcome back to the Rollercoaster Review Show. We're here at SeaWorld Orlando and we're here to review Icebreaker. Icebreaker is a premier ride skyrocket coaster featuring a triple launch, a forwards and backwards launch, as well as a top up and a big old scorpion tail which you go up at the start. Quite a short layout to be honest, but we'll see how it is. So you now join us on Icebreaker for our first ride. Seems interesting. I've got a transfer track as well, so it's a bit different. And got a couple of colours, a bit like Tigris. Got a nice view of the new B&M surf coaster. It does look quite good. But the reason why we're not reviewing Mako or Mantra, Mako, I wasn't sure getting on, but good news, I did get on Mako, so, and Mantra. Here we go, backwards first. Okay. So good, yeah. Start. Whoa, a bit of airtime there. Whoa. Oh, that's a nice little bit of airtime there. Gonna get it again. And big thoughts. And whoa. That was quite a lot.
They need to do something about these lap bars though.
Yeah.
Really unpleasant when you get thrown into the park.
Yes. But yeah, and that was Icebreaker. Yeah, I may look different right now, but it's a few days after our first rides on this. So my thoughts on Icebreaker. It's a really fun ride. Layout's pretty fun. Yeah, it's a little bit short, but it works really well. At the front, it's actually really smooth, which is quite a surprise. At the back, you get more airtime. So I imagine the middle is a mixture of both. Yeah, a bit of a mixture of both. But honestly, it's a really good ride. It's going to get 4 stars. Just enjoyable. The only one problem with the coaster is that it's a train. Trying to get in and out of the coaster, absolutely horrible. Just horrible. And having the comfort colour is absolutely horrible. And honestly, Premier needs to do something. It's not the park, it's Premier needs to do something. They did fine with Skyscreen at Holiday Park. That was absolutely awesome, then, the trains. But this, no. Have the comfort colour. Trains can't really get in and out that easily. That's the only downside of this. But overall, it's a fantastic little ride for the park. But that does it for Roller Coaster Review Show today. Thank you for joining me, thank you for listening and everything like that. This is officially the last review of the year of 2022. We are going to be flying into the new year straight away in January with a brand new review. Yeah, I will see you all soon. Goodbye for now. Also, that does look awesome over there. One day we'll come back and do this. Train at all times. Hold on to your lap.